But this this is a song I wrote about O'Donoghue's pub. Back in the 60s, I was a denizen of that place. I lived across the road, and it was wonderful. I mean, I'd like to dedicate this to the memory of wonderful Paddy and Maureen O'Donoghue, who sometimes we didn't get on with that well, but I was thinking today about the bank strike in 1967, which I'm sure you all remember. Paddy, you know, there was no cash, and there was no chance of changing checks, and we all ran up these ferocious slates in O'Donoghue's. And when it was over, finally, many months later, Paddy said, "Oh yes, Andy, I think you owe me about £7.50. Paddy, you'll go broke at this rate." And anyway, this is dedicated to them and to the late wonderful Ronnie Drew, who is very much the leading force in O'Donoghue's back in the 60s.
I was just thinking about it. The first time I went into O'Donoghue's myself, I was barred because my hair was too long.
It was August 1962 when I first set foot in O'Donoghue's. A world of music, friends and booze opened up before me. I never could have guessed as I walked through the door just what the future had in store. A crossroads for my life I saw lying there to taunt me. Well, I was an actor, I played straight, I played in the gaiety, played at the gate. My mother in 1928 had trod those boards before me. I was getting tired of the company, an actor's life did not suit me. I said goodbye, you'll never see me back here in Neary. Johnny Moynihan, in his fusty coat, was the first to play there in Merrion Row. When they brought the bazooki to Ireland, you know, way storm along John. Paddy and Maureen O'Donoghue, Kieran Burke, Lou Kelly, Ronnie Drew, Barney McKenna and me and you, in the early 1960s. Well, Paddy and Maureen, very, very sound, though she liked to camp on the moral high ground. You had long hair, you were go down your blood-red roses. Ronnie Drew in his fine suit of blue and a voice like gravel that would cut you in two. We thought he was Dublin through and through, but he flew in from Dunleary. John Kelly in the front bar, their fiddles up from the County Clare. Joe Heaney sings in the cold night air, in the laneway after closing. Our sea shanties in perfect tune, and Seamus Ennis in the afternoon. It was all over much too soon, days of wine and roses. Well, Banjo Bar, you call it a tune, Mary Jordan's a whiz on the spoons, up the Swanee until the brew. Barney's rising to it. They carry him bodily out of the jacks. He empties his bumper and they carry him back. He swallows his pipe and he's right back on track. How the fuck does he do it? How it's been my time was never in doubt. This is what life was all about. A bowl of soup and a pint of stout. August fog, a meat shoot, marathon shame. Dave Smith never never short of a witty phrase. Sonny Rogan loved the way he plays. Ted McKenna, God bless the days of Italian mandolinos. At closing time, we didn't go far, just down the road to the Pipe Coffee Bar. The usual suspects, there you are. Have yous no homes to go to? Putting up a note on the message board, Sweeney's men have a gig, oh Lord. We have to meet at 12 o'clock for the journey down to Galway. But the Sweeney van broke down at the door, and we didn't get started till the 4:15. To the merry chin of the Dolan snore, all the way me Rosie. It all came to an end in 68. The rest of the world was lying in wait, and I started out for a new landscape. Set sail for the Pyrenees Mountains, from the old North Wall, sailed away, and all my friends were there on the quay. Won't be back for many's a day, but it was bloody great while it lasted. It was August 1962 when I first set foot in O'Donoghue's, a world of music, friends and booze hastening towards me. I never could have guessed as I walked through the door just what the future had in store. A blueprint for my life I saw lying there before me.